So there is what I was going on about that, because what I love about this is you're supposed to be playing the villain. I mean, I'm Black Adam.
I'm Harley Quinn.
I'm Black Manta, a character I've never really heard of.
So
beyond in this game.
He's super awesome.
So he's Aquaman's villain.
Oh, okay.
And I'm not as intimately... I read the first volume of Aquaman from the New 52 when Geoff Johns was writing it. It's only 12 issues. It's not a lot to give you the entire background. All I gotta say is, man, Black Manta, dude, he's a... I understand why Aquaman needs to stop him. He's a bad dude.
Isn't he like an eco-terrorist?
That's kind of what he comes down to. I don't know, like, his entire history. I know in this one, because of course they had to do it, it makes it more dramatic. Aquaman accidentally, mistakenly, kills Black Manta's dad. And, you know, vengeance, man. Vengeance, the dark side. It's ugly. Yeah.
Yeah.
In the book, it wasn't like, I don't think Black Adam and Harley Quinn actually worked for the villains. Like, she's an anti-hero. Black Adam's actually an anti-hero, too. He just desperately wants to protect Kondak. So I don't think he actually worked for Ultraman. But in the story, Ultraman and the rest, they enslaved the Earth's villains. So that's kind of where it's coming from. You play as one of the villains attacking the Justice League. And I think that's the coolest thing ever. I love this game. This is too awesome.
It is awesome. Especially because as playing the most popular of all the villains, Harley Quinn, I think inherently I'm going to win.
That makes sense.
So, we're just going to play convention style, all cards on the table.
And since I'm playing the villain to the hero who feels like the least popular hero of all time.
Yes,
feels like. Now, I don't know if he really is.
If you've been following him since the New 52, Jeff got a hold of him for great purpose. Well, no, because he was... Because the 70s were not caught up on that.
Jeff saved this character, blah, blah, blah. And then Jeff came in and he rewrote this character.
Geoff Johns deserves respect. Because what he touches is gold. And
is he the one they're putting in charge of the movies now?
Yeah.
Yes, okay. He is the Stephen King of DC.
Because he got a hold of a guy like Aquaman, and I think he only wrote him for 24 issues, but still.
He's the Stephen King, or is he more like the, what's it called? Who's that guy that they have redoing every movie now? He did the Star Trek movies over again.
Oh, J.J.
Yeah, J.J. Abrams. Like, he comes and fixes new series.
No, where the only way I can describe it is Jeff.
I think probably J.J.
Well, I mean, I don't know. Because J.J. kind of goes like his own direction with everything.
Yeah, Jeff, but he makes it better. And then they just follow that direction.
Jeff doesn't necessarily make it like, this is how to... Jeff doesn't necessarily make it better. Mm-hmm. He just understands the leg... Because these guys have been around for 75 years.
Yeah.
He understands where they come from. He understands what about them made the character work.
Mm-hmm.
And he uses it. And, like, that's the same thing with Aquaman. Like, he doesn't, like, stress out over him riding seahorses or talking to fish. Mm-hmm.
That was the best part of the cartoons.
Well, those were pretty good.
Okay, so Aquaman... is pretty awesome in the New 52s, but having said that, of the original, five heroes that, like, most people know, the ones who made it to TV, he is the least popular of those characters.
Well, they have ridiculed him over and over again.
But they kept bringing him up as, like, oh, like, the whole point of the Entourage series was that they were going to make this Aquaman movie. And, like, for two seasons, they're talking about making it, and they're just making fun of how bad it actually would be to make an Aquaman movie. And now I think we're going to have an Aquaman movie.
And like, everybody's defense, because we did have Batman 66. And that was a pretty goofy time for Batman. And yet nobody thinks of Batman as... Well, I mean, granted, you have to have Frank Miller give Batman some of his balls back.
A lot of people still like
him. He started the Dark Knight series, right?
Yeah. He wrote the Dark Knight series.
That's what actually brought him back, though.
It is what brought him back, but Aquaman isn't his Dark Knight series. Maybe that's the problem. Maybe there needs to be Aquaman the Dark Fish or something. I don't know.
The Dark Seal.
Yeah.
Dark Seal rises.
No, starting with the New 52, Jeff's run. Aquaman. Aquaman's a pretty dope guy. Black Manta, like, I really want to see Aquaman beat him. He's a terrible guy.
In the Flashpoint cartoon, Aquaman was pretty badass. The Flashpoint cartoon they made.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, here's the one thing I don't remember. Do we repopulate before
immediately.
Yep.
Okay, immediately. Okay. Oh, there's your hammer.
There's my hammer, the mallet.
Mm. Reveal the top card of your deck, draw it, or pass it. Oh, okay, obviously, yeah. Speaking of Flash and Flashpoint, I'm constantly impressed by that shit, because Flashpoint is such a gigantic story. And it obviously is. It was another crisis story.
Sure, sure. Yeah.
It immediately led to the birth of the New 52 universe. Mm-hmm. And Berlitani doesn't have nearly as much to work with. Right? He doesn't have Batman, who played a big... Batman slash Thomas Wayne,
mm-hmm.
who plays a big role in that story. Wonder Woman, Aquaman. He doesn't have any of that stuff. But they still wanted to do the story. And I think they've done their best. They hit on what was the biggest thing about Flashpoint, and that's the fact that after it happened, it changed everything. And now they're dealing with the repercussions of that.
It's a great show. I haven't watched this season's Arrow yet.
I can't.
Neither have I haven't recorded.
I didn't even finish last season.
Really?
I liked last season.
Damian Dark. I actually like the actor. He played Dark quite a bit.
But he's a great actor.
His character, the plot, wasn't compelling. All right. Three power cards I'll go back.
I probably should have done that, too.
Yeah, jumping into here before getting those...
is just not as smart as I was
thinking.
You don't
need to worry about that. There's some great cards out
there. I mean, Element Woman, actually...
Yeah, I was actually thinking I should have gotten hers with a hammer.
Are you done?
Yep.
Alright.
Holy shit.
Yeah,
you want that
instead? Well, no, I couldn't afford it, but remember what Black Adam does?
Yes.
And it obviously makes sense. It's a great... Right, Element Woman has like four primary elements and she mixes them to do different things. While you own or are playing this card, it is also a superpower equipment and villain card.
Mm-hmm.
You go.
Okay, I drew the three punches I had left in the two vulnerabilities, so I will purchase a kick because that is what I can purchase.
Okay.
And I will put that at the bottom of my deck because I want to have that.
Just his special ability is Black Manta.
Black Manta's special power is putting cards at the bottom. Yep. All right, I got four power. I'll buy Element Woman. I'll get out another card. We got Blackgate Prison. It's a location. Ongoing. Once during each of your turns. Each of your turns. Okay, yeah. Reveal the top card of your deck. If it's a vulnerability or a weakness, destroy the game. That is phenomenal. Obviously very opportunistic, but you get to get rid of the bad cards.
Yeah. That's why I got the mallet, because I was hoping that's going to help me.
Shift around the bad cards.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna buy the Royal Flesh King.
Damn. We're just trying to do the Anthony.
Well, Harley Quinn does very well with the Royal Flesh King.
Wait, guys.
Does the Royal Flesh King move cards right?
Draw two cards and discard two cards.
And she works on discarding cards.
And she works in discarding.
Okay, so one thing real quick.
Sure.
So the first card I draw would be the mallet because I put that on the bottom of my deck.
Yep.
That was the extra card.
Yep.
Now it says reveal the top card of your deck and draw it or pass it to the player's discard pile.
Yep.
Now is that immediately or is that during my turn?
You play it.
Okay, got it. That's what I thought.
But you're playing it now, so.
Well, I'm not playing it yet. This is my hand. I'm just showing what my hand's going to be.
Oh, no, I see what you're saying. Yeah. Okay.
So, top card of your deck, draw it, or pass it to any player's discard. I will use the mallet right away. Vulnerability, I will give it to your discard pile.
I didn't know you wanted to lose today, Ramsey.
Hey, I'm spreading out the love. He'll get the next take, don't worry. I have 4 points.
That was brave.
I was really brave.
You never target lightning first.
I don't appreciate it.
When you play this card, leave it in front the rest of the game.
So in theory, that gives you a permanent power for the rest of the game, presuming that the rest of us don't get rid of it somehow.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because every turn he just gets to use it and make his deck leaner. It's a great card.
If I have vulnerabilities and weaknesses.
And there's going to be things that give you weaknesses and vulnerabilities. And
mm-hmm. Okay, I guess I'll buy it. And we'll see how
it doesn't go out immediately, though. I think it goes right to your discard.
Oh, you're right. I'm sorry. I'm going to put it on the bottom of my deck.
All right. Ooh, look at that. I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Oops.
Dr. Light. Draw a card and choose a foe. Attack. That foe puts a location he controls into his discard pile. So we got the Firestorm Matrix.
Is Dr. Light... actually, I don't even know who Dr. Light is.
I don't...
I thought he was a bad guy from Flash.
I've seen him a lot. He's kind of like a B-rate DC villain.
Yeah, he is a villain.
Why is he a hero?
That's what I was wondering. That's why I was like, how is he a hero?
In the New 52, they were changing him up a little bit. And then kind of like... I don't know if he... Superman killed him. Atomica was inside of there causing trouble. Like, seriously, that's what she did. She was Earth 3's Atom.
Sure, yeah.
So got tiny, hopped inside of stuffed a fucking piece of kryptonite instead of Superman's brain. His lasers just shot out. And he killed Dr. Light. And but like he wasn't dead. He was kind of coming back.
Yeah.
So there was something there, but like comic books do, they just kind of... I never saw it play out. But I know Dr. Light as a villain. And honestly, kind of one of DC's like... I think one of DC's like weaker moments, because he raped some superhero,
okay,
and then like he wouldn't let that go. He's like, "Oh, look at this! This is Dr. Light, the rapist." Okay. It's like, "Fuck! Just punch him and throw him in jail!" Like, my God. Anyways, six. Could I buy two of those?
Yeah.
Power plus power equal to your victory points. If you have 5 or more victory points, destroy this card at the end of your turn. Plus 1 power for each villain you play. You know, I'm going to take a risk. I'm going to buy 2 more picks.
I think that was actually a good risk. I don't think I've been buying enough.
I can use that. It's just because it works super well with Black Adam's power. But at the same time, there's no like real strategy or focus with my deck right now.
So. Yeah, no, I don't really have one either. Okay, 4.
I just imagine writers in shared universes like destroying other people's characters by making them do something so unforgivable that's it. They're like, I hated Dr. Light. He's ruined. I think I've heard of that happening to some other characters.
Some other writer gets a hold of him and then just like does not. Or who was that? Because I don't follow the Bat family very much. But I know it's definitely happened in a Bat family before.
I'm
it's
the
like.
Kick and I'm putting it in the bottom of my deck.
I hate Robin.
Like some guy doesn't like Tim Drake or whatever.
Yeah.
And so barely uses him. When Tim does show up, he's kind of like. Or maybe Damien. Yeah. Writers. All right. 3 power.
Dr. Light. Team Light.
Now that you said he's a rapist,
I know exactly. Nobody wants him.
No, I like so.
We don't need YouTube hate off of picking Dr. Light.
There's a lot of things I really liked about the New 52, and I was okay with them reinventing Dr. Light. They kind of gave him what seemed like a dramatic. Maybe they were keeping the rape thing. I kind of feel like they were like, "You did a terrible thing, Dr. Light, that you can't come back from." I couldn't tell if it was murder or something else. And then Superman kills them.
So is that a thing that you can do with the Royal Flush
Gang? So Royal Flush Gang makes me draw 2 cards and discard 2 cards.
Okay.
So I drew 2 punches, so I'm discarding a punch and a vulnerability.
Yeah.
And then my ability is the first time I pass or discard, I draw a card.
That's awesome.
Boom. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Oh.
which
so close yet so far away.
So I want the mallet. Unfortunately, I just may only get the mallet because all of that.
You didn't actually get what you wanted.
Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
Venom injector. When you destroy this card in any zone, if you actually look at the rule, there's like in play or whatever. It doesn't matter where you destroy it though. Mm-hmm. When you destroy this card in any zone, gain 2 power.
Okay, I'm gonna put down Blackgate Prison. So if I draw a vulnerability or a weakness and I destroy it, I get a victory point.
Cool.
So it's not really all that big of a deal. Now I have.
Well, at the start of every turn, just look at your top card.
Yeah, I have 5 points.
Damn.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Now, Bellevue, this one just automatically gives me +1 power, right?
Yeah, if you
for
play
each villain you play. Ooh, but it's kind of hard getting villains, it seems like.
No, we just haven't drawn them yet. They come out just the same as the hero cards. We've been getting a lot of equipments.
Yeah, we have been. And I did what's it called? I did shuffle it really well.
Yeah, that was really that was a big mistake, dude. But here we are.
One job.
I don't like any of you. I just want you to know that. Actually, before I buy this, I'm going to buy this. Can you reveal the top card, please?
You're being sad, Ramsey.
What? Oh, okay, here we go. Emperor Penguin. This is another one that I haven't seen since the new 52.
Okay. You don't make me sad.
He was kind of weird.
Wait, are you buying that too?
Yeah.
He shows up.
So lame.
He shows up like halfway through the Batman story, and he's just a meaner version of the Penguin.
That is so silly, but what does he do? When you destroy this card in any zone, gain 2 victory points. Okay, I will buy him as well, and I will put him here. And then I will buy a kick. Oh, wait. Actually, yeah. I'm sorry. Flip it.
Oh, Pandora's Box. Reveal the top card of the main deck. Add cards from the main deck to the lineup equal to the revealed card's cost. So when you want, you increase the amount of cards on display.
So you could buy more cards. Well, everybody can buy more cards, actually.
Yeah, it just helps everyone.
That's true. But it gives you first dibs.
Yeah.
Except it costs one of your cards in order to do it.
Yeah, I'd rather just buy this. And I'll put this at the bottom of my deck. And then I will put these in my discard pile.
All right.
And at one, because the location's out, I will see if the top
He only get to do that at the start of his turn?
Once during each of your turns.
Oh, you can do it whenever you want.
So this turn, before my turn ends, I'm going to, and it's a kick, so I do not want to discard that.
I think you can just put it back to the top.
Yeah.
This is a reveal. Yeah, yeah. Reveal goes back.
Yeah.
And then you draw it because it's...
Why not? Turn. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
All right. All I got is 3 power. I'll buy another kick.
All right. Punch, punch, Deathstorm. I will destroy vulnerability.
Good for you. And what does that give you? Power
nothing.
Equal to the cost of it or
nothing.
Something?
I just destroyed it. It just leaned my deck down. That's cool. What Deathstorm does. So then I have only 2 power, so I will buy, I guess, Pandora's Box, because I can't do anything else.
Amanda Waller. You may destroy a card in your hand or discard pile. If it's a villain, plus power equal to its cost. If you choose not to, plus 2 power anyways.
Okay, I will use Blackgate Prison real quick to see if the top card is a vulnerability or a weakness. It's a punch, so I'll put it back. And I have 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. No, I have vulnerability. Damn it. That sucked. 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, I'm sorry. What did Waller do? Let me see.
Basically, she lets you trim villains out of your deck and get extra power for it. Or you get 2 power anyways.
So she does give +2 power regardless. And she costs 4, which means I can't get a kick. But no matter what, it gives me 2 power. So yeah, I'll buy her. Why not? And then can you reveal one? Because it might just be that it turns out to be something that's only 1 point, because that only costs
3
me 4.
A villain.
Nope. Okay.
All right, hey, Rich, you gotta help me. Like, the first time you play a superpower,
yep.
During each of your turns, you may destroy it. If I destroy it, do I not get its plus two power anymore?
You don't, yeah. Wait.
Oh, I think you do.
No, you
it.
Played it, so you did.
Yeah, you get the plus two power, then you destroy
I just don't get it back into my deck.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Play the top card of your deck. I'm looking at the Firestorm Matrix. If its cost is five or less, so I play this one from the top of my deck, and it's five or less, you may destroy this card. That's why I destroy it.
Wait, that wasn't the top card on your deck, though.
If you do...
Oh, okay, got it.
If you do, leave the card you played in front of you for the rest of the game, and it has... ongoing. You may play this card... Oh, so you just start... Like, you can start building up.
It'd be two power every turn.
Just there, sitting, waiting.
But then you don't get victory points for it.
At end of game, destroy it. Well, that's why you don't, because at the end of the game, you... That's super, super interesting.
But you only have six.
What? God damn. I'll buy Manbat.
Really? What are you going to do with the other three power? Get another kick?
Maybe.
Or Dr. Light?
Or another villain. You may destroy a non-villain card in your hand or discard pile. If his cost is one or greater, gain one VP.
I'll buy Atomica. I'll destroy this card.
And you were just talking about Atomica.
She didn't get like a huge spotlight, except for she's the one that like tricked everybody into allowing the Earth 3 villains over. The cold gun, plus one power. You may put a frozen token on a card in the lineup if you do.
I remember that.
I remember Rich playing that to
screwing me over several times because I couldn't buy cards I wanted.
Rich knew exactly what he was doing.
All right, Deathstorm, not going to use it. Pandora's Box. It's four. So.
Holy crap.
Oh, wow.
But when any of these go away, they don't come back, right?
Yeah, correct. Just out of curiosity, Rich.
Mm-hmm.
Like specifically these or any card until we're back down to five?
Down to five.
Yeah,
it doesn't matter.
Got it.
Yeah.
In case anybody was like me and thought that way.
Yeah, I was kind of curious too, actually, when you mentioned it.
Four,
five. Good for you, buddy. Good for you. Okay, so Blackgate Prison, I'll reveal it.
Mm.
And it is a kick. And I will use the mallet to reveal it, and then draw it or pass it. And I will draw it. What?
You want to pass it?
No, I'll draw it. So put it
late
there.
You might just randomly be like,
oh, yeah, of course, Rich. What?
And wait. I'm going to destroy this card to get two victory points.
How are you
going to
destroy
it?
It's actually an effect you have to activate.
Oh.
You're going to get a lot of these cards allow you to destroy things.
Hmm.
Which is
destroy this card
really
in any
like
zone plus two
thing.
Power.
I do.
So equipment, that doesn't go out and stay. That
so kind of weird. Equipment is played identical to other cards. Only it's in a class of equipment. So you're going to get things that say, hey, destroy villains, destroy heroes.
Okay.
So obviously they don't work on equipment, right?
I think, spend it here, but let me see. Is this equipment? This is superpower.
Yep.
So this will give me plus two power, basically.
The advantage is, if you notice, look at the victory points. I think it's a little bit higher.
Yep. No, they're both one.
Oh, does she cost less?
Just cost
then?
Less. Costs two. But it's like, I might as well just get it.
Okay. My turn.
Put it there, and that's it.
Blah, blah, blah. Three power.
Alrighty. Mallet. it's a punch, I guess I'll draw it. And that lets me draw a card, because I'm Harley Quinn. Which, unfortunately, was the card that I would have wanted to get rid of. Except Royal Flush King, I'm then going to draw two cards. And then I'm going to discard two cards. And that gives me 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 power. It's a lot of work for not much power.
Yeah, I thought you were going to be like, and there's 10 power.
We're going to have to get to a point where we're, like, whittling our decks down.
Yep.
Well, I hope so.
So yeah. I bought a power drain, and that's all I can buy, so.
Okay.
4, 5. I will use my Blackgate Prison.
Right, that's right.
To check, and it's a punch, so I'm not going to get rid of it.
Yeah, that's how this works.
And I'm going to put down Giant Growth, Amanda Waller, punch, punch, punch. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, which isn't, if I just had one fucking kick, or fudging, I could have taken out Flash. Oh well. But
you get
7.
The Firestorm Matrix, that's a pretty powerful card.
Yeah, I kind of didn't understand it though.
So basically what you're doing, it words it a little bit weirdly, but this is basically what you're doing.
This card.
You're taking a card from the top of your deck. If you like, if you always want it out, maybe it gives +3 power or whatever. Make it a permanent. It stays out forever. And you always get its effect. Well, you always get this effect here on the bottom. The thing is, though.
Well, there's no effect on the bottom, though.
Ongoing.
Oh, the card.
Oh, so whatever it is, okay.
You just goes off every turn.
You may play this card once during
each turn. So if I had a kick with it, then it would be powerful, because then it's like every turn I'd get a kick.
Yeah, and the only caveat, though, is.
At the end of the game, you don't get the bonus points.
So you
could lose a hero that way, right?
Yeah.
You could.
But having a ton of kicks out there, like, that's actually kind of valuable.
Yeah.
All that extra power.
Yeah, that's actually the exact reason. But hold on. Wait, I did do Black Gate already. Okay, yeah, so can't do it again. Cool. Okay. Your turn.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 power. Oops.
Dang, look at you.
Cosmic Staff +2 power. Defense. You may discard this card to avoid an attack. If you do, gain the bottom card of the main deck. It's kind of
that's a nice card.
I want to buy a Bell Reeve.
Cool.
Oh, the Blight. You may destroy a card in your hand or discard pile. If it's a superpower, plus power equal to its cost. If you choose not to, +2 power anyways. Blight was kind of a cool Justice League Dark villain.
All right.
He was like the personification of all the evil that was happening. He just showed up and Justice League Dark, being the supernatural heroes that they are, I had to try to put them under control.
Power drain. Ramsey, let me see your hand. Unless you have a defense card.
Let me see, do I?
Yeah, all the cards are like defense, right? You can play them from your hand?
Yep.
Do you use the defense power? Yeah.
I do not have one.
All right, let me see. And I just get to discard a card. Let's discard your mallet.
Damn you.
I'm Harley Quinn. The only one who gets to use mallets is me.
Oh, man.
All right, Royal Flush Gang. So I draw 2, discard vulnerability, and a punch. And that's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 power, and I will buy the Cosmic Staff.
Of course you will.
Will I?
It's good.
It is good, honestly.
You shouldn't do it, though.
but I'm actually going to buy the Blight plus the Cold Gun. Well, I'm going to buy the Blight, and then let's see.
Draw another card, yeah.
Giant Growth.
I would prefer the Giant Growth.
Power Girl. A hero card. Just 3 power. My turn.
No, it's not your turn. It's my turn.
Damn it! I really want to go.
You cheater!
I got some cool stuff ready to happen.
Well, all I get to do basically is draw this kick because I only have 3 power because I drew 2 effing vulnerabilities at the same time.
Did you use your Black Gate thing?
No, now I will use it, and it's a kick, so I'm not going to burn it.
Okay, my turn. All right, check this out. So first, I'm playing Bell Reeve. Check it +1 power for each villain I play. 1 punch. 2 kicks.
But no,
Man-Bat. So Man-Bat is effectively 3. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'll beat the Flash. That's it. I beat the Flash.
Okay. So,
Superman.
First appearance. Each player destroys a superpower in his hand or discard pile. If you cannot gain
Wait.
Yep.
The first time I play a superpower, I blow up Kick.
Okay.
And get the... I forgot to do it last time. I didn't backtrack. But in this case, unfortunately, I'll blow up Kick again.
I'm going to blow up Giant Growth. Superman.
13, man.
So just a superpower or what?
Just a superpower card. You got to blow it up.
Damn it.
Yep. Or gain 2 weakness cards. Yeah. If you're Bizarro, you would take 2 weakness cards.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm actually kind of disappointed we didn't get Bizarro. He's a cool dude.
Wait, but for me, weaknesses actually aren't as bad. I'd rather take the 2 weaknesses when I think about it.
Cool. Really?
Yeah, because if they're the top card, then I can discard them with Black 8 and get a victory point.
True. There's some
He's
random,
a gambler.
Yeah, there's the gamble. That's for sure.
All right, here. Okay. So let's just see. Mallet. I will draw it. And that's going to be 2, 4, 5 power. And I will go ahead and buy the Cosmic Staff. And then, that's it.
So did you buy the Cosmic Staff?
I did.
Did you already flip a card over?
He did. And it's another one, the same one.
Man-Bat Serum. No, there's 2 of them.
Huh. Okay, my turn?
No, it's not.
Damn it!
It's still not your turn.
Damn it! Can we just have this out of the video? 3 times is getting kind of silly. 3 or 2 times.
It's like a Family Guy episode.
It really is, yeah.
Just beat the same joke over and over. Hey, Ramsey, is it my turn?
Did I do my Black 8 prison thing yet?
You did not do
Black 8. Okay, then I will do Black 8 prison before I discard those cards. It's a punch, so I will not get rid of it. And that will go here, and then I have to shuffle this. So, now it's your turn.
Okay. All right. Atomica. I can destroy a card in my hand. I'll destroy 1 ability. I don't get any victory points for it, though. 1, 2. No power for her. 4. You know, for now, I want to take the Man-Bat Serum.
Flip a card.
I'll destroy Kick. Gain 1 victory point. Gigantica. +4 power. If they're there. Poor typos. If there are no cards with cost 3 or less in your discard pile, otherwise it's only +2 power.
Alright. Pandora's Box. Reveal.
Oh.
That's 4. Oh, yeah.
It doesn't matter. Because of Bell Reeve, Atomica. I actually got 1 power for Atomica, but I don't think it would have made a difference. So. Okay.
Constructs of Fear. I don't think there's many of those in the deck. I don't remember seeing a lot of them. All right. 3 power.
+3 power. Mm. Cost 7 to grab, though. Attack. Each foe discards 2 cards. Good God.
That's awesome.
Brutal card.
That's right.
Because we've got all these extra cards now.
What is her thing? She's a defense also?
Stargirl. Yeah. She gets 2 power. Her defense is you may discard this card to avoid an attack. Mm. If you do, draw a card and put a card with cost 1 or greater from the destroyed pile on the bottom of the main deck. And you have to do that if you use her as a defense card. It's not a may.
So she starts bringing people back.
Basically, yeah.
Okay. So, have you gone yet?
I did, yeah.
Okay, so my turn. Punch, Emperor Penguin, which is worthless to me. Because I can't destroy cards.
and Firestorm Matrix. I will use Firestorm Matrix. Let's see, what's the top card? Hopefully it is a kick. Perfect. I destroy it, which gives me the ability to give +2 more. So
you put the kick on your character card? Because it's permanent for your deck now.
Yeah, but I need to... Firestorm Matrix...
Oh, is that destroyed too?
No, it stays out, and I can keep using it each turn if I want to. That's the thing that's weird about it. Like, I could stack up kicks even on this.
I
just don't get the points at the end of the game.
No, so you're using...
This stays out.
Yes.
This goes back in your deck. You can't just keep discarding cards every turn. It's an equipment card, not a location.
Why does it say ongoing? You may play this card.
No, this card gains. It says it has.
The card gains that effect.
So now you get to play a kick for the rest of the game.
Okay.
Because it has.
Oh, okay.
Well, the previous sentence gives you context for who it is.
Yeah.
You're the it.
Well, no, it's important.
That would be amazing if you could just...
When you use a word like it, like context becomes...
Yeah.
Yeah, no, you're correct. 2, 3, 4.
Giganta is a 4. Amanda Waller is a 4.
And they're both powerful for different reasons.
She's +4 if
you have cheap cards in your discard pile.
3 or less, I think.
So basically, you gotta look at your deck.
This is my only because I have some fours also.
You gotta look at your deck.
So she's not that powerful.
How many cheap cards do I have?
Amanda Waller.
Am I going small? If I'm going small, which there's something ironic in there. If you're going small, Giganta's the one you want.
I'll take the defensive card, I guess. Well, wait, actually, is Waller worth more? No, no one's worth more. So
points? Yeah.
I'll just take this one. Like, you guys can do so much more points each turn than I can. I don't understand what I've done wrong here.
We'll reveal everything to you at the end.
Save that for the review.
Oh, I hate you in so many ways.
Is it my turn? Ramsey?
Oh, wait, you know what? No, I was wrong. I had more points. Hold on. I might not have bought this. Hold on. 1, 2, because I have 4, but I have 2 more here. So I have 6.
Yeah, I guess you do that.
Yeah, because I forgot about that.
Power Girl.
That's what I would have wanted instead, was Power Girl. Because what is this one worth? Or what does this one do?
Destroy a
hero in the lineup.
Destroys heroes.
+1 power. It only matters if you've been destroying heroes. Destroy pile. So I could take him, start destroying heroes, and then I get +1 power for each hero that I destroy.
Well, each different hero.
Yeah.
So, well, I mean, if you destroy like a bunch of Star Girls, that doesn't matter. But you destroy all 3 of these, now he's +3.
Yeah. So I'll just do Power Girl for this time.
Okay. My turn?
Yes. No. Wait.
Bunch of cards with all of the.
Oh wait! Last thing I do is Black 8 though. Oh. It's a kick, so I'm not gonna throw away.
Put out all the cards. It's 8 power. 2, 4, 6, 8.
Okay.
Destroy the kick. Pull out the power ring.
Very nice.
The only problem is that I don't have any of the things that let me trim my deck very well. I haven't seen all those cards come out either.
No, I haven't either, and I bought cards that were dumb to get because I don't have ways to destroy things.
That's it. Amanda Waller.
Does she do the same thing Power Ring does, but against villains?
No, it destroys a card in your hand or discard pile.
Okay.
Okay, I'm going to try to reveal a card for Black Gate Prison.
But if it's a villain, you get a bonus.
Yeah.
It doesn't do anything. So then I will also reveal it again.
I'm kind of going with like a villain
this
deck.
And get to draw it.
But obviously I might need to like grab Amanda Waller or something. It's
+1.
So I have like more options to clean my deck with.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I have 8 points, so I can get the 7. Is he worth getting?
Dude, he's super aggressive.
+3 power each. Foe discards 2 cards. Huh. Yeah, that's not bad. I will get him and put him on the bottom of my deck.
Oh, vibe. +1 power. You may put a hero or superpower with cost 5 or less from your discard pile on the top of your deck. Vive, the legendary Flash support character.
Oh, Vive?
Not at all. Okay. They just made Cisco into Vive on the Flash show. It's fine.
I know. I watch the show. I like it a lot.
Well, I'm just saying
I call it Stampy.
This is who Cisco's character was based off. Or part of his character was based off of. My turn?
Mm-hmm.
I don't get to do anything. Just two oh, well. You know what? Fuck you guys. I'm buying the cold gun.
I knew you were going to do that.
I only got two power.
Flip the other one. You know, I don't know how much power I was talking
about. A weakness card.
That should not be there. There you go. That's.
You can't put
one. No, but that is one less now.
Oh, yeah.
Instead of one more.
Oh, shit. Ultraman. You may destroy a card in the lineup. Plus one power for each different superpower in the destroyed pile. So kind of what Rich was saying. That the destroyed cards are pretty darn important.
Hold on now. So.
Fucking Ultraman. They had like some... At least some of them, they told you like the origins of these guys back from Earth 3. You know, Ultraman's origins on like the twisted version of Krypton.
Okay.
And like how the family was like... Basically, the Kryptonians were fighting with each other desperately because only the strong got to survive.
Yep.
Okay, guys,
my turn, right?
Oh, yeah, sorry. I forgot. I'm being like Leiden now. What a dick.
All right, first of all...
I'd say something about it.
Word of power.
Uh-oh.
No, that's not the word of power. I'm not using that yet. Power drain. I really want to make Ramsey discard Amanda Waller because he tried to cheat and skip my turn.
Hello, he's the one that keeps cheating, not me.
Oh, okay.
However, just out of balance, I'm going to discard one of your cards.
Do you get to pick?
Yes, he gets actually pick.
Power ring.
He's like...
This is such garbage.
He's like, let me tell you what it was. But you're going to discard now.
Okay. I am going to destroy a kick out of my discard pile using the Blight.
Mm.
That gives me 3 power. So 3, 5, 7, 8. I will buy an Ultraman.
Oh my god, you are devastating me.
Invulnerability, plus 1 power, big defense card. When you are attacked, you may reveal this card from your hand. If you do, you may discard it or destroy a vulnerability in your hand or discard pile to avoid an attack. That's huge.
Well, it's your turn, Ramsey.
Thank you, sir. So, why do I have to be just shy? So, I can destroy a villain, which I have one here, that's 7, or no, that's this one right here, that's only, his cost is only 1, but by destroying him I get 2 victory points, so I will do that. Actually, no, you know what, I'm not going to do it this time. I'm not going to do that because instead I'm going to destroy a weakness. Although it doesn't give me this ability, but... Actually, no, I want to get rid of vulnerability.
That one minuses points.
Oh, you're right, yeah. Weakness. So it was back in the weakness deck, I'm assuming. Yeah. And then I will...
Did you destroy it?
Oh, wait. What?
Did you destroy it?
Yeah, I used her to destroy it.
We can put it in the discard pile. I don't know that it...
I can't remember if a card, like, it's stronger.
Yeah.
But just in case.
So it gives me, what, 1 power? Or, no, 0. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. I've got 4.
Stargirl. Invulnerable.
What's the other hero?
Vibe.
Does he do anything fancy?
You may put a hero or superpower with cost 5 or less from your discard pile on top of your deck.
course, Ramsey would hire Dr. Light.
Draw a card and choose a foe. That foe puts a location he controls into his discard pile. So this just gives me an extra draw.
Yeah, I mean, if somebody had like a really powerful location card, you could keep kicking it off the battlefield.
But he is all about rape, so I mean, I don't know if I can, in good conscience, take him.
We have people in the comments like typing in like,
that's not what Torque to Light's about.
He beat down some guy and nobody would like forgive him for beating down Robin. And be like, how did you go so like wrong with Dr. Light? I don't know. That's just where Leiden, we trust Leiden.
This is really his, like, you look it up. That's really his story. Pre-Crisis or whatever, or pre-Flashpoint was his story.
But they fixed him now. Now that never happened.
But no, now he just doesn't. He's not a thing anymore because they just stopped writing him.
Oh.
Okay, I'll get Stargirl, I guess, at this point.
Okay.
Ba-bum. He kind of confuses me because when I see Dr. Light, I kind of think Dr. Fate.
Before
it's maybe that's where they go.
So,
Dr. Fate is DC's Doctor Strange.
Yes.
Yeah, but they both have like a yellow theme. So.
Yeah.
And there's blue. Lots of magical yellow effects around Dr. Fate. So, yeah. All right.
All right. Well, Rich hosed me.
Makes sense.
But anyways, 1, 2, 3, because of Belle Reve. 4, 5, 6, 7. So I'll buy Giganta. I'll buy a kick. I'll destroy a kick. Which is an Iron Man somewhere. I won't get to use my Man Bat Serum now. If you have 5 or more victory points, destroy this card at the end of your turn. Oh, but I still get all the power from it, so. I just have to destroy it when I do finally draw it.
It's not a power, it's a superpower, though.
Your turn.
Yeah.
It's not. No. I'm just saying the card forces me to destroy when I have more than 5 victory points.
Yeah.
But I still, at least in one moment. So if I had 10 victory points, well, then there you go. All
right, Power Drain. Ramsey, let me see your hand. There's not much there.
Oh, really? Is it this time?
A kick. I'm just alternating to show that I'm not... even though I think Leiden is sort of...
Leiden is way ahead of me right now.
I know, but...
Like, it makes no sense.
I've only killed one hero, like...
That makes you way ahead of me. And also, he knows you're the only one out of the two of us that can reach a 13. The most points I can possibly reach...
I'm scared of your Firestorm Matrix, though.
It's only 2.
Plus, for now, the next time you play, it's going to be 4. And the next time is...
If I get a kick, what if I pull something that's worthless?
I hope you get a weakness.
Yeah. I mean, not...
I hope I do, too.
Not that I'm trying to pull a Ramsey and, like, aimlessly misdirect. But something that's hurting me a lot right now, I'm not exactly sure what I'm going to do about it. I don't have enough cards that let me trim my deck. And that's...
Me neither.
It's only going to hurt me.
I concur.
Oh, God, Rich. You're not going to be the one who takes Dr. Light.
I have to be, I think.
Probably. Can we make a house rule?
No, actually, though. I'll probably take Invulnerable.
Can we make a house rule where we just get rid of Dr. Light?
Nope. It's there.
It's there forever.
Cosmic Staff again. Okay.
Hey, Rich, how good is Cosmic Staff?
It's okay. Plus 2 power. Oh, it's actually pretty decent. It's 2 power. It's
this, so no, I don't want to get rid of it.
It's what? 2 power and it's a defense. You may discard this card to avoid an attack. If you do, gain the bottom card of the main deck. So there's like a lot of gambling there. We know you love gambling.
I like gambling. I'll buy that.
And some, man, dude, sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't. Like it's a fucking trip every time. Happy Harbor. Oh, this location. So this was kind of cool. Because one of the first things the Earth 3 villains did when they came over was they dropped the Watchtower into Happy Harbor.
They like picked it up and just dropped it?
No, we got like 2, 3 really powerful dudes, Ultraman and Superwoman. So they just fucking, they punched it really hard.
The Watchtower, is that the one in space,
normally,
right?
On a harbor?
So,
Watchtower is the satellite.
So famously, yeah, there was space, the Hall of Justice.
Yeah.
And when that stopped being cool, Batman bought a satellite. Because, you know...
Space station that's so futuristic, it has artificial gravity.
The weirdest thing about that, right? The weirdest thing about that kind of stuff, fucking space station with artificial gravity? Why are there still wars on Earth? We apparently also got infinite energy.
I actually sort of wonder, like, I know why, but personally, I would be more interested in the Marvel universe. I love Marvel, by the way. I'm not implying I don't. But I would be more interested if they had extended the storyline logically to, like, where's the Mars colony? Where's these other colonies?
Yeah.
Because it should just be like an alternate storyline, and they just keep going and going and going, and just things get crazier and crazier. I don't know. I'd like to see.
I'm with you. Like, I'm okay if the superheroes have a watchtower.
Sure.
But then make a part of that universe, a part of that version of the Earth that their version of Obama is dealing with or whatever, is the fact that we got a Martian colony.
Yeah. Well, but only if whoever the super genius is actually sell their stuff and don't just make it themselves like a, what's it called? Like,
kind of
Fantastic
Four,
Mr. Fantastic.
They make a bunch of stuff and never sell it.
Yeah, which doesn't make any sense. But, so I mean, they're heroes.
Well, and right, we don't need to beat a dead horse, but one of the worst stories ever, One More Day, Aunt May's got a bullet in the heart. Are you fucking telling me Reed Richards and all the rest can't fix that? Just saying.
Wait, who had the bullet in the heart?
One More Day was a terrible way to hit the reset button on Peter Parker. It involves some sort of attack happened. Mm. Aunt May gets a bullet in the heart.
Oh, okay.
And Mephisto makes a deal with Peter, saying, right, Mephisto, the Marvel devil.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
Saying, hey, I'll save your Aunt May for you, but you're going to have to give up something. Gave up his relationship with Mary Jane and all that history. A bullet in Aunt May's heart. I mean, it's like Tony Stark literally had that problem 60 years ago, and he's okay.
Yeah.
Like, Aunt May was fine. Peter really should have talked to one of his buddies.
Yeah,
fucking Doctor Strange. Doctor Strange, literally a heart surgeon. Isn't he a heart surgeon? Literally a surgeon or a heart surgeon? I swear to God, if Doctor Strange is a heart surgeon plus magician, and Peter doesn't talk to him first?
Oh, whose turn is it?
It's Lightning's.
Yeah, it's my turn. I got Flash. Draw three cards, then discard one.
Oh, that's so bad.
Oh, sweet, sweet. I'll
Flash would be perfect for Arlequin's power. So.
Oh, yeah.
I'll discard the vulnerability. You may destroy a non-villain card in your hand or discard Powell. Destroy the vulnerability.
Oh, and by the way, the reason we're always deferring to Leiden on DC is because he knows the most about DC.
I like DC. I really dig it.
If it was Marvel, he'd be just spewing out, like, BS. Well, constant BS. It'd be like, yeah, the Hulk, I think his powers are derived from the sun. What?
What? No. Dude, I don't know what it is. Like, there's no logical. I just don't get into Marvel. They don't.
You're a DC fanboy. So it's okay. Things, right? It's
there's
okay.
So many anime universes out there that are totally legitimate.
Yeah.
Sure.
But you just can't get into everything.
Sure, sure. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, because, like, learning about what's all the different things that have happened in DC, man, that fills the cup up fast.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's it. Just 5 power.
For all that craziness.
You know what the heck? Let's go with a hybrid deck. Happy Harbor. Or go with the Demand Bat Serum. I'm just going to discard it later anyways. Oh, another cold. Oh, by the way, I have a cold gun. What do you guys want the most? Nobody wants to touch Dr. Light.
No one really cares for anything right now that's out there.
Vibe isn't terrible.
We're all trying to get Superman.
But nobody's.
Yeah, we're all trying to defeat Superman at this point. Nobody's after we can because there's nothing to
do. Oh, heck, I want to use the cold gun to freeze the cold gun. Wait. Token. Yeah, I need a card in the lineup. So.
Nope. Turn over frozen, right?
Oh, okay. What's the other side?
The other side is something else. Like, this card cannot
be. Oh, it's just telling you what frozen means.
Yeah.
Cool. Done?
Yeah, I'm done.
All right. Pandora's Box.
Oh, you shit.
Pandora, man. You're
5. Wow.
Damn. Wait, do you draw this out and 5 cards or up to that number?
Up to that many.
Okay, okay.
So 3, 4.
Yeah, that's pretty intense.
5.
All right. Oh, shit. Another Construct of Fear. That's a super powerful card.
All right. Mallet. Oh, I got a shuffle. That sucks.
Wait a minute.
All right. vulnerability. I will pass it to Leiden. Because I hear he's really good at weaning down his deck. And then
definitely not good. The second I even get slightly ahead, I'm weaning my deck.
I'm activating Harley Quinn's power to draw a new card. Nice. So, Power Drain. Let's go ahead. I think it's your turn this time. Look at your hand.
I used it last time. You used it
last time, actually.
Sorry.
Not to mention, you're winning.
Rich will be losing. Do you really want to commit to this?
I have to.
You don't have to. You don't have to. You don't have to. It's literally the realities. You don't have to.
Harley Quinn doesn't care whether this action will cause her to lose.
You're doing this to yourself.
So what is going on here? I guess, ideally, we get rid of Element Woman so you can't activate your power on it. That just seems logical to me.
Exactly. Literally what I was
going to do. I mean, Man Bat Serum gives you a ton of power.
Literally what I was going to do.
6, 7, 8. Yeah, that's fine. All right, so now what do we have? Royal Flush King. So draw 2 cards.
God, man, you are powerful this turn.
And then discard 2 cards.
Well, he needs to have big cards for it, but...
He might be able to take Superman now.
So let's go ahead and do Power Drain. Power Drain.
You got 2 power. Oh, Jesus.
Construct of Fear. And then.
I literally don't have shit. Like, Ultraman even with that, I didn't have
anything. Destroys a superpower. Let's go ahead and destroy Construct of Fear. Wait, do I want it? Each foe discards 2 cards.
If you attack with it, so you have to use it to attack. Not to buy stuff.
No, you can use it. That's just how it works.
You get to use attack at the same time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, you do?
All the things happen on every card.
Oh, I thought it was only if you attack one of these.
Defense is the only special thing that you play from your hand.
Mm. So, I will destroy the Construct of Fear. It is kind of awesome. But how many superpowers are over there? 1, 2, 3?
Just 3 so far.
Just 3. So, 3, 5... 6, 7. That's it. Just 7.
Yep, that's what I had.
Oh, Phantom Stranger. You know, I'm pretty sure Phantom Stranger is a Golden Age hero.
He's like not good though if you have more than 10 points or something, right?
The same thing I already have. So, I'll buy Phantom Stranger and I will buy... a 2.
Mm. You can get a 1.
Let's do an Emperor Penguin.
Alright, wait, we don't replace those.
So, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Harley Quinn making things crazy.